Ever since the Sauber of Felipe Massa passed Jenson Button into Turn 1 at the very first Chinese Grand Prix in 2004, Shanghai has consistently provided close racing and extraordinary memories. It's where Lewis Hamilton effectively lost the title in his rookie year, and it's where Nico Rosberg claimed Mercedes' first win of the modern era in 2012. Shanghai International Circuit then, a 16-corner high-speed thrill ride. The long and ever-tightening right-hander at turns 1 and 2 tests a driver's patience, and the flat, open to the element's location, tests their skill in a crosswind. Two DRS zones will assist passing, and overtaking is available into turn 1, and of course down the kilometre-long back straight into the hairpin at turn 14. Joining me once again to take you through this race is the effervescent Anthony Davidson, and I'm very much looking forward to it getting underway. You raced here, of course, didn't you, back in your Super Aguri days in that infamous Chinese Grand Prix of 2007?
Yeah, that's right. I didn't last that long, though, unfortunately. Qualifying had gone pretty well, but my brakes failed quite early in the race, around lap 10 or 11, something like that. And of course, back in 2004, I was the very first Formula One driver to complete a lap of this circuit. Just thought I'd mention that for you, Crofty. You like a good stat. It's a fairly tough circuit on the brakes here, though. You know, it's that long back straight down into turn 14, and then you got turn 6 and 11. They're quite heavy as well. On top of that, managing your front tyre wear is always a challenge around here, so there's a lot to keep in mind during the Grand Prix.
Okay, here we go. I know what you can do. Don't let me down.
Well then, after an exciting qualifying session yesterday, let's take a look at how the cars line up. An immense lap from Lewis Hamilton yesterday puts him on pole position, with Nico Rosberg alongside. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Vettel, Raikkonen, Daniel Ricciardo, and Verstappen, a McLaren, Bottas, Massa, and Carlos Sainz. Hülkenberg, Perez, Kevin Magnussen, and Palmer, Kvyat, Ericsson, Felipe Nasser, and Jenson Button. Wehrlein and Harry Anto, Romain Grosjean and Esteban Gutierrez completes the grid. Now it's almost time to lights out, so let's go down to the track.
situation, but I don't think we have cause to move on to a different tyre yet. is 2.2 seconds. 7 seconds. tyres.
A great win then for the Mercedes team today. And I have to wonder, Anthony Davidson, just what set them apart from the competition here?
The difference was clearly in the strategy. You could tell they'd done a lot of work on the pit wall to really optimise each stint and get the most out of the tyres. And it highlights just how much of a team sport this really is. But credit to the driver as well, though. There's no good having a well-oiled machine behind the scenes without a talented hand on the wheel, of course.
And here are our podium drivers today after that excellent race. They've excelled here, as they so often do, and it's a well-deserved victory. Mercedes, then, are on top today. Now let's take a look at the driver's standings. It wasn't the best weekend for our championship leader, and their advantage at the top has been reduced. And now I'd like to ask you, Anthony Davidson, who was your driver of the day?
Look at where Romain Grosjean finished compared to where he started. That's a really strong performance, so driver of the day has to go to him, I think.
And here's how things are shaping up in the Constructors' Championship. Mercedes have extended their lead at the top of the standings. Meanwhile, good work from Force India this weekend, who pushed themselves further up the order. It was great having you with us for this weekend. I hope you enjoyed it as much as we did. Until next time, though, goodbye.